Hello students, students today we are just continuing your previous chapter, so let's get started. Class 5th, we are continuing your chapter number 10 geometry. Today we are starting a new topic, that is your triangle. So I have drawn a triangle over here. What is a triangle? A triangle is a polygon made up of three sides. Okay, so what are the sides of this triangle which I have made? It's a AB, okay, then BC, then CA. So it's having three sides. These are the sides of a triangle. Okay, these three are sides of the triangle. Now a triangle is having three sides as well as three angles. 1, 2, and 3. So the name of these angles can be written as angle A, angle B, and last one is your angle C. Okay, so how many sides? Three sides and three angles. Now these corners are also known as your vertex. Okay, so how many vertices? This is one, this one is your second, and this one is your third. Okay, so a triangle is having three sides, three angle, and one name of its vertices I am writing here, that is your A, B, and C. Clear? So a triangle is a three-sided polygon having three sides, three angles, and three vertices. Clear? Next, we are having classification of triangles. So basically, triangles are classified according to their sides and according to their angles. First, we will study their classification according to their sides. So first is your equilateral triangle. Now, equilateral, the name indicates itself that equal. So, if the three sides of the triangle are equal, so if I draw a triangle over here and I take its sides at 3 cm, this one also 3 cm and this one also 3 cm. If all the sides of a triangle are equal, then the triangle is said to be your equilateral triangle. Okay? Next is your isosceles triangle. Now, what is an isosceles triangle? I draw a triangle over here and in this I can say that this side is of 3 cm. This is of 3 cm and I take this one as 4 cm. You can see that two sides are same and one is different. So a triangle in which two sides are same, any two sides, if this and this, any two sides are same, then the triangle is said to be your isosceles triangle. Next is your skeleton triangle. Okay, so if I made a triangle like this, in which this side I take as 5 cm, this as 4 cm and this one as 3 cm. You can see all the three sides are different in measurement. Okay, so if all the sides are different, then the triangle is said to be your skeleton triangle. Okay, again I'm repeating, equilateral means all three sides are equal, isosceles means any two sides are equal, and skeleton triangle, no side is equal. Clear? Now we will study classification of triangle according to their angles. Next, we are having your classification of triangles according to their angles. Okay, so first is your acute angle triangle. Now, acute, I told you what are acute angle? That the, if the angle is less than 90 degree, then that angle is said to be acute angle. Suppose I have drawn a triangle over here and I named it and I give them, like this angle is of 80 degree, this one is of 50 degree and the another one is also of 50 degree. You can see each angle of this triangle, it means all the three angles are smaller than 90 degree. So when all the three angles of the triangle are acute or less than 90 degree, then the triangle is said to be acute angle triangle. Okay, next is your right angle triangle. Again, I told you that what is a right angle? Right angle means angle of 90 degree. So, when one angle of a triangle is right angle, then the triangle is said to be right angle triangle. So, if I draw a triangle over here like this, okay, this angle is of 90 degree. I told you 90 degree angle will be a straight line. So, this angle is of 90 degree. Consider it as 60 degree and this one as 30 degree. Okay, so you can see that one angle in this triangle is 90 degree. So, the triangle is said to be right angle triangle. Keep one thing in mind that if you are making a triangle as a right angle triangle, then there should be only one angle of 90 degree. Now, why this I will be explaining you later on, that it is a property of the triangle that the sum of all the three angles of a triangle must be equals to 180 degree. Now third is your obtuse angle triangle. Now what is your obtuse angle? I told you an angle which is greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree is said to be obtuse angle. And what is your obtuse angle triangle? One angle of a triangle is an obtuse angle. So if I have drawn a triangle over here like this, okay, and I consider this angle as 130 degree, this one as 20 degree and this one as 30 degree. You can see in this triangle one angle is obtuse, okay. So if in a triangle one angle is obtuse angle, then the triangle is said to be obtuse angle triangle, okay. Next we are having properties of a triangle, okay. So we are having two properties of triangle. First is, in a triangle the sum of the measure of any two sides is always greater than the third side. It means if you draw a triangle and you sum the measure of any two sides, it is always greater than the third side. So I take example of this triangle. If I add side AB plus BC, okay, so what is your AB? That is your 4 centimeter. What is your BC? That is your 6 centimeter. It is always greater than, what is the third side? AC. Now AC is 5 centimeter. Now 6 plus 4 will be 10 centimeter is greater than 5 centimeter. Okay, any two sides. Suppose you are adding AC and BC, then it will be 6 plus 5 will be 11. It is greater than the third side. So this is the property of a triangle, that the sum of the measure of any two sides is always greater than the third side. Clear? Next property is very important property, which is also called the angle sum property. Okay? Now what is the property? This property says the sum of three angles of a triangle is equals to 180 degree. Okay? So if I consider this triangle, this is angle A, this is angle B and this is angle C. So your angle A plus your angle B plus your angle C is always equals to 180 degree. The sum of three angles of a triangle is always equals to 180 degree. It could not be more than 180 and it could not be less than 180. It is always equals to 180 degree. Now we will do one question of your exercise 10.7. That is your question number 5. Now what they have given you in this question, given a triangle PQR, they have given you a triangle PQR. This is the symbol of triangle, okay. Find all the angles of the triangle. You have to find all the angles and show that the sum of three angles is 180. You also have to show that the sum of these three angles is equals to 180, okay. Now they have given you angle R is equals to 58 degree. This they have given you. Now come to your angle Q. I told you that if you got a straight line and you have this symbol, then this angle must be equals to 90 degree. Clear? Now you only have to find angle P. Now I told you a property that the sum of three angles of a triangle is always equals to 180 degree. Clear? This I have told you a property. Okay, now what is your angle P? Angle R, that is your 58 degree. And what is your angle Q? That is your 90 degree and you have to find angle P. Clear? Now I told you that that angle or the term which you have to find, keep it only here only and take these two over that side. So 58 plus 90 will be 148. So this becomes angle P is equals to 180 minus 148. Okay, I have added these two and then when I have taken it to other side of equals to, it comes in minus, it changes its sign. So this shows you angle P is equals to 32 degree. Now what is your angle P? Angle P is equals to 32 degree. So we have done the first part. We have find all the angles, that angle R is equals to 58, angle Q is equals to 90 degree and angle P is equals to 32 degree. They also told you that show that the sum of the three angle is 180 degree. Though we have proved it here also, but for solving, just write down 32 plus 58 plus 90 degree. That is all the angles I have written. Okay, angle P, angle R and angle Q. And when you add these three, you are getting 180 degree. It means the sum of three angles of a triangle is equals to 180 degree. So this is the way of finding the one angle of a triangle when they have given you two. Add the two angles which they have given you and separate the sum from 180, and you will be getting your third angle. Okay.